Hello everyone. In previous lecture we already discussed the first colligative property, that is lowering of vapor pressure. In this now we discuss second colligative property, that is elevation in boiling point. Elevation in boiling point. What is boiling point? We know that boiling point for any liquid is a temperature at which the vapor pressure of that liquid becomes equal to the atmospheric pressure. Vapor pressure of that liquid becomes equal to the atmospheric pressure. That is, at normal temperature for any liquid, vapor pressure is less than atmospheric pressure. With increase in temperature, we know that with increase in temperature, vapor pressure of any liquid solution increases. When we supply heat, temperature of liquid solution increases, and at a specific temperature that vapor pressure of that liquid becomes equal to the atmospheric pressure, and at that temperature liquid start to boil, and that is nothing but boiling point of that liquid. We know that when we added non-volatile solute in liquid solvent, its vapor pressure decreases. Its vapor pressure decreases. That is, vapor pressure of solution is always less than vapor pressure of pure solvent. Then, because of this, if we compare solvent and solution of same solvent, for any specific temperature, vapor pressure of solution is always less than that of pure solvent. Therefore, if we plot the graph of change in vapor pressure with increase in temperature for pure solvent and solution, as vapor pressure of solution is for any temperature is less than that of pure solvent, therefore that graph of solution is placed below the graph of vapor pressure for pure solvent. In this figure, that line graph 1 shows change in vapor pressure with increase in temperature for pure solvent, and second line shows change in vapor pressure or increase in vapor pressure with increase in temperature for solution. Initially, at normal temperature, vapor pressure is less. If we consider solvent, pure solvent graph 1, then as temperature increases, at specific temperature, say T0, at temperature T0, that vapor pressure of solvent becomes equal to the atmospheric pressure, and that P0 is therefore vapor pressure or atmospheric pressure. That P0 becomes equal to the atmospheric pressure, and therefore that T0 is nothing but boiling point for pure solvent. And if you consider solution graph, then increases temperature for pure solvent, for solution, then its vapor pressure, that is vapor pressure of solution, is less compared to pure solvent. Therefore, for solution, vapor pressure become equal to atmospheric pressure at slightly higher temperature, that is at temperature T, that vapor pressure of solution becomes equal to the atmospheric pressure, and therefore T is nothing but boiling point of solution. And that difference here, see, T is greater than T0, and that is boiling point of solution is greater than boiling point of pure solvent. This is known as elevation in boiling point. That is due to addition of non-volatile solute. In solvent, vapor pressure of solvent, boiling point of solvent, vapor pressure of solvent decreases, and therefore in solution, therefore due to addition of non-volatile solute in solvent, boiling point increases. This is nothing but elevation of boiling point for solution. And here that difference between boiling point of pure solvent and solution of same solvent is nothing but delta TB. Here given is delta T, but actually that one is delta TB, small b. Delta T, capital T base 2, small b. Delta TB is boiling point elevation for solution, and that is equal to T minus T0. Then mathematically, we know that this elevation in boiling point is colligative property. That means that depends on concentration. That is number of solute particles present in the solution. And for mathematically showing that relation between delta TB and concentration, that is M molarity, we consider that Clapeyron Clausius equation, or Clausius Clapeyron equation, that original equation we already studied at SYBSC level, that is ln P1 upon P2 is equal to delta HV upon R in bracket 1 upon T1 minus 1 upon T2. That P1 and P2 and T1 and T2, that P1 and P2 that are vapor pressures, and T1, T2 temperatures for solution and solvent. That are replaced here in this case by P1 is nothing but vapor pressure of solvent, that is in this case that one is P0, and P2 is vapor pressure of solution, in this case that one is P, and T1 is boiling point of solvent, here that one is T0, and T2 is boiling point for solution, that is here considered T, and therefore that equation becomes here as ln P0 upon P is equal to delta HV upon R in bracket 1 upon T0 minus 1 upon T. Then we know that for dilute solutions, that by solving this equation at here in bracket term, bracket terms become T minus T0, in bracket, that one is nothing but delta TB, and here upon T0 into T, then that T minus T0 is nothing but delta TB, and here we know that for dilute solution that elevation in boiling point is very small, that is difference between T0 and T is very small, and therefore that is considered as equal, T is considered as equal to T0, and therefore T0 into T is considered equal to T0 square, and therefore that equation become ln P0 upon P is equal to delta HV upon R into delta TB upon T0 square. Here we increase one step as minus ln P0, minus ln P0 upon P becomes equal to R T0 square upon delta HV into delta TB. Consider that one step here, further rearrangement, only consider here minus ln P0 upon P is equal to delta R T0 square upon delta HV into delta TB. Then according to Raoult's law, that minus ln P0 upon P is equal to N2 upon N1. We already explained this in previous lecture. That is, minus ln P0 upon P is equal to N2 upon N1. We know that N2 is nothing but number of moles of solute, and N1 is number of moles of solvent. Then that N2 is equal to W2 upon M2, and N1 is equal to W1 upon M1. Substitute that values, that N2 upon N1 becomes equal to W2 upon W1 into M1 upon M2. Substitute in above equation that minus ln P0 upon P is nothing but N2 upon N1, and N2 upon N1 is nothing but equal to W2 upon W1 into M1 upon M2. Therefore, that equation becomes, and by rearranging this equation, we got value of delta TB as delta TB is equal to W2M1 upon W1M2 into RT0 square upon delta HV. Then here, delta that HV is actually, here we know that heat of vaporization per mole, and so as to convert that into per gram, here that one is nothing but we can write as delta HV upon M1. That is, that one is nothing but heat of vaporization of solvent per gram. Instead of per mole, this one is per gram, because here given delta HV is per mole, heat of vaporization for solvent per mole. That one convert we into per gram by dividing it into molecular weight of that solvent, that is M1. And then substitute that, and according to definition of molality of solution, M is equal to moles of solute upon amount of that solvent in kg, that is W2 upon M2, that is moles of solute upon W1 weight of solvent upon 1000, that is in kg, therefore upon 1000. Here therefore molality M is equal to 1000 into W2 upon W1 M2. Therefore M upon 1000 is equal to W2 upon W1 M2, W2 upon W1 M2. Then substitute that value of W2 upon W1 M2, that value of this term is becomes equal to M upon 1000. Substitute in above equation, and by rearranging we got the relation, that is delta TB is equal to M into RT0 square upon 1000 LV. LV is nothing but heat of evaporation per gram. Then that M is considered 1, molality of solution is considered 1. Therefore, that this equation become delta TB is equal to RT0 square upon 1000 into LV. RT0 square upon 1000 LV is, all terms are here constant, R constant, T0 constant, 1000 constant, LV, that is heat of evaporation for pure solvent per gram, which is also constant term. Therefore, all terms are here constant. Therefore, that delta, this RT0 square upon 1000 LV is considered as a new constant, which is nothing but denoted by KB, and that one is known as cryoscopic constant or ebloscopic constant or molal elevation constant, KB. Therefore, by substituting that KB here in the equation, delta TB is equal to KB into M. Delta TB is equal to KB into M. That means here, when solution is 1 molal, that is M is equal to 1, that delta TB becomes equal to KB. Delta TB becomes equal to KB. Therefore, what is definition of that KB? KB is molal elevation constant. It is defined as increase in boiling point of 1 kg of solvent when 1 mole of solute is added in it. What is KB? It is equal to TB. When M is 1, KB is equal to TB. That KB is nothing but it is increase in boiling point of 1 kg of solvent when 1 mole solute is added in it. And this equation also indicate that delta TB is, KB is constant, therefore delta TB is proportional to M. Delta TB is proportional to M. That is, that elevation in boiling point, delta TB is nothing but elevation in boiling point, that is T minus T0, elevation in boiling point, is nothing but it proportional to M, means it depends on concentration of solution, that is it depends on number of solute particles in solution. Therefore, it is colligative property. And this equation shows the change in boiling point, that is elevation in boiling point, is directly depends on molality of solute, and it depends on nature of solute. Hence, it is colligative property. Then here, for different solvents, that value of KB is, that ebloscopic constant is different. For water, it is KB value is 0.52. For methanol solvent, it is 0.82. And for ethanol, it is 1.20. Hence, these are values given for KB for different solvents. Then, what is use of every colligative property? It is very useful for accurate determination of molecular weight of that solute added in a solvent. For solute, any solute, that may be benzoic acid, that may be sugar, that may be NaCl, for any solute, we can calculate accurate molecular weight of that solute by measuring this value of colligative property, that is delta TB. Examples are given here, different examples, and for objective examination there may be small such type of example also given for exam in objective question. Therefore, solve small examples like this. A solution of 2.2 gram diphenyl, that is C6H5, twice in 100 gram benzene boils at 80.84 degrees Celsius. Calculate molal elevation constant of benzene, that is, and boiling point of pure benzene is 80.1 degrees Celsius. That given terms are W1, that is weight of solvent is 100 gram, and W2, that is weight of solute added, is here diphenyl, that is 2.23 gram. M2 here formula is given, C6H5 twice for carbon 12 and hydrogen 1 molal, atomic masses. Therefore, that molal mass becomes equal to 1, M2 becomes equal to 154. And by substituting all the terms here, that KB is equal to 2.62. Similarly, here some examples also given for calculation of M2, that is molecular weight of solute. Practice for such type of small examples that may be asked in your exam. Thank you. In next lecture, we discuss second property, that is next colligative property, third one, that is diffraction in freezing point. Thank you.